myself Nicholas Barla. I am coming from place called Orissa, from Sundargarh district. I belong to Urao, a scheduled tribe community or indigenous people community,
what we call.
See, I have been involved with the different issues and problems of the local indigenous people, whom the government of India and government of Orissa call scheduled tribes, Adivasis, all different names it is given. See, historically, the indigenous community, we are experiencing exclusion and discrimination in social, economic, political, education, health, service, all different aspects in our area. And therefore, we are trying to bring the people together. Unfortunately, now, in the name of development, the government and different companies, they have come to our area, which is full of mines and minerals, and they are taking our lands. So many of the indigenous communities are displaced. The famous Rourkela steel plant is in our area, which was built in 1954. You can see, till now, the displaced people are not being rehabilitated, not properly compensated, and no promises were fulfilled. So people are still agitating for their demands. Though in our land, we have so many good constitutional provisions, many laws like fifth scheduled areas, where the governor is given the role to play to protect and promote the tribals' rights, to protect their lands, and to educate them, to develop them. But this governor is not doing his role, and that therefore people are still under development. The tribal land should not be transferred to the non-tribals, but today openly, in collaboration with the district administration and the company people, all our lands are being transferred to the non-tribals for the mining operators, for the industrialists. So this way, how people we are facing totally displaced. And here in our area, Tata, Birla, Essar, Jindal, Mittal, POSCO, Vedanta, all these companies are coming and they are almost taking our land. In one of the cases, 14 people were shot in Kalinganagar by the Tata company. So what we need is to recognize the tribal rights, respect our existence, and implement the laws so that the indigenous communities, the poor people, they live a dignified life. And this is how I expect. So, goodbye.
Thank you.
Myself, Nicholas Barla. I am coming from a place called Orissa, from Sundargarh district. I belong to Urao, a scheduled tribe community or indigenous people community,
what we call.
See, I have been involved with the different issues and problems of the local indigenous people, whom the government of India and government of Orissa call scheduled tribes, Adivasis, all different names it is given. See, historically, the indigenous community, we are experiencing exclusion and discrimination in social, economic, political, education, health, service, all different aspects in our area. And therefore, we are trying to bring the people together. Unfortunately, now, in the name of development, the government and different companies, they have come to our area, which is full of mines and minerals, and they are taking our lands. So many of the indigenous communities are displaced. The famous Rourkela steel plant is in our area, which was built in 1954. You can see, till now, the displaced people are not being rehabilitated, not properly compensated, and no promises were fulfilled. So people are still agitating for their demands. Though in our land we have so many good constitutional provisions, many laws like fifth schedule areas where the governor is given the role to play to protect and promote the tribals' rights, to protect their lands and to educate them, to development them, but this governor is not doing his role, and that therefore people are still under development. The tribal land should not be transferred to the non-tribals, but today openly in collaboration with the district administration and the company people, all our lands are being transferred to the non-tribals for the mining operators, for the industrialists. So this way how people we are facing totally displaced. And here in our area, Tata, Birla, Essar, Jindal, Mittal, POSCO, Vedanta, all these companies are coming and they are almost taking our land. In one of the cases, 14 people were shot in Kalinganagar by the Tata company. So what we need is to recognize the tribal rights, respect our existence and implement the laws so that the indigenous communities, the poor people, they live a dignified life. And this is how I expect.